ЗИС. Изначально этот зенитный ракетно-пушечный комплекс создавался как машина прикрытия для длинной руки российских ВВО. Комплексов С-300 радиолокационная станция многофункциональна. Она способна самостоятельно обнаруживать цели как в небе, так и на земле. Это необходимо как в случае выхода из строя станции обнаружения, так и в случае, когда СОТ просто не нужна. Например, если машина стоит в ущелье, можно направить луч МРЛС навстречу цели, и она просто-напросто сама влезет.
Машина в его положении. Высота 260. Вот. 202-й сопровождаю, дальность 10, высота 260, скорость 40. Сопровождаю МРЛС.
Thank you. Rosoborom Export and Russian Helicopters are presenting the Ka-52, a new generation scout attack helicopter. Its power plant includes two powerful VK-2500 engines rated at 2400 HP each. The helicopter uses a high-performance coaxial rotor. An important feature of the Ka-52 is the absence of the tail rotor, which significantly improves the efficiency of helicopter control and flight safety. The absence of power consumption by the tail rotor, combined with a high-performance rotor, gives the Ka-52 a 20-25% advantage in thrust-weight ratio over all known attack helicopters in the world. As a result, the Ka-52 offers unparalleled maneuverability and an unprecedented hover ceiling out of the ground effect of around 4,000 meters, which exceeds the hover ceiling of all known attack helicopters around the world by an average of 800-1,000 meters. The service ceiling of the Ka-52 is at least 5,500 meters. Stores are mounted on 6 hard points. Increased maximum weapon load and longer maximum flight range with maximum weapon load are the competitive advantages of the Ka-52 over other attack helicopters. Suggest that side-by-side layout of pilots in the Ka-52's cockpit is most appropriate to conduct reconnaissance missions. The shared use of information coming from radar, electro-optical systems, and navigation aids by the two pilots simultaneously reduces the search time and improves target recognition reliability. When an emergency landing of the helicopter is impossible, a crew ejection system is a reliable means to save lives of the pilots. Both crew members are ejected simultaneously. In this case, helicopter rotor blades and cockpit canopies are first jettisoned automatically, and then rocket ejection units are activated. Ejection is provided throughout the entire flight altitude range of the helicopter, including at the zero altitude. When the helicopter conducts regular flights in isolation from its main base, it requires no test equipment, ground support, or special aircraft equipment for its maintenance. In case of self-contained basing for 2 weeks, maintenance can be done by the helicopter crew. The Ka-52 accommodates a built-in performance monitoring system, an independent power supply source, the TA-14 power unit, and mechanical systems for weapon suspension built in the helicopter wing. The Ka-52 is designed for operation in desert, tropics, mountain conditions, and at sea, in the range of ambient air temperature from 50 degrees Celsius minus to 50 degrees Celsius plus, and at relative humidity of 95-98%. An important feature distinguishing the Ka-52 from other attack helicopters is its out-of-hangar operation. It has outdoor storage and service, without any shelters, using only covers and standard blanks. Its avionics suite has been developed using the most advanced digital data processing and data exchange technologies and combines high-precision inertial satellite and radio navigation systems, digital helicopter navigation automation system, a set of reconnaissance aids, including target search and track electro-optical and radar systems, as well as an onboard communications and data transfer system, weapons management system, and helicopter self-defense suite. The open systems architecture of the avionics suite makes it possible to include some systems into it, both as an option and instead of existing ones. Helicopter, the round-the-clock combat capability. Pilots fly the helicopter at night wearing night vision goggles, using an infrared illuminator, thermal imaging, and radar terrain mapping on the basis of data surveillance system and digital terrain maps. The crew carries out search, target acquisition, and aid firing at night using an onboard radar, a day-night surveillance and sighting system, as well as external designation data. The GOES-451 day-night electro-optical surveillance and silence system includes TV search and sighting channel, thermal search and sighting channel, laser targeting channels for Vihar and attacker type guided missiles, laser rangefinder, target illuminator. Electro-optical countermeasure system is designed to protect it from engagement by surface-to-air missile SAM systems, including manpads and anti-aircraft artillery systems, by detecting the threats and using countermeasures against attacking weapons. Movable 30mm 2A41 cannon, 460 rounds. S-8COM unguided rockets with heat fragmentation warheads, up to 80. Vihar and attacker-type air-to-surface missiles. Up to 12 such missiles can be installed on board the Ka-52 helicopter. Igla-S air-to-air guided missiles. Up to 4. date, the Ka-52 is unrivaled in mix of armaments and their firepower. The effective firing range of its cannon and unguided rockets exceeds the similar indicator all known attack helicopters in the world by 800-1000 meters. The range of Fisher anti-tank guided missile is still unsurpassed and is at least 10 kilometers. The Vihar missile flies at 600 meters per second and is superior to all known anti-tank heliborne missiles in speed in its class. The Ka-52 helicopter has no equal in conducting operations in the mountains due to its unmatched operational altitude and unique maneuverability. Its high thrust-to-weight ratio provides effectiveness in hot climates. The uniqueness of the helicopter is also in its versatility in performing both reconnaissance and strike missions. The helicopter is unique for its universal in both reconnaissance and attack missions. Its capability to save the crew from any emergency, fly in any weather and climate, as well as self-containment and out-of-hangar storage, continue the best traditions of the Russian helicopter industry.